Barbara Hillmore, and I am from, actually I was born in St. Louis, Missouri in 1942.
Okay. Ms. Hillmore, what are some of the principles you live by?
Well, it's interesting to try to verbalize what you live by. In fact, I don't think I think about it. I just live hoping to treat people with respect and dignity and the way I want to be treated. And I try to do something for someone every day of my life. I learned that from my mom and grandmother, and it's served me well.
Okay, great. And reflect on some of your proudest accomplishments, and if you wish, even your more disappointing, bitter disappointments. So if you want to share one of each or some of each.
Well, actually, I've been very fortunate in my life. I don't have any huge disappointments. I'm very proud of a number of things related to my work. I'm on the faculty at SMU. I've been there 35 years, and that alone has been quite a journey. And in that time, I've worked very hard to make a difference in the diversity in the arts college especially, which is where I teach. And specifically, since I've been there, I started a foundation, nonprofit, foundation benefiting scholarships for minority students. And most specifically and lately, in fact, on this coming Sunday, we will celebrate my foundation 10 years of giving scholarships to South African singers. And I go every year to South Africa and work with young people there in townships and in schools and churches, colleges and universities, trying to identify career talent. And when I do, I make recordings of their work and bring it back so that they are considered for admission to SMU. So I've worked very hard for that. And in fact, in 10 years, we've brought 16 foreign students to SMU. But at the same time, we've given summer study awards and living awards to students from all over the world throughout the years. And so I started the foundation in the late 80s, and thank God we're still, even though we're not as prosperous as we could be, we are still working very hard for young people in the arts. So I suspect of many things that I'm very proud of. That's probably one of the source of some of my great pride.
Okay, great, great. And which time period, like as far as your age, what years have you enjoyed the most? Or maybe not a good answer to that, but just what do you...
Well, you know, it's so funny. People, when I was younger and on the stage a lot, I'm an opera singer, and people used to say, what role do you like the most? And I always said it's the role I'm doing. Because for me, the joy is in the work, and it didn't matter what I was doing. And I feel very akin to that with the times of my life. I can truly say I've taken advantage of every time in my life, and I've been fortunate to travel all over the world, to meet people and make friends in countries I never would have imagined even seeing, and now I frequent. And so I can say this is the most important part and time of my life, because I'm living it. And when I think of what's been the most important time, that's how I feel, the time I'm actually in. Mm-hmm. I loved the time when my daughter was a baby, and Yeah, and she could go everywhere with me. I loved taking her with me everywhere, and I loved the time when she grew up because I was very proud of the young woman she became. And when she went away to law school, and then when she started to work, and I thought, well, I'm just so proud, but actually I'm happy at every time of my life. I believe we have to live in the moment, take advantage of the time and the opportunity.
Okay, great.
Of the moment.
Okay. Yeah. And one last question. If you could give advice to a young woman coming up, young girl, what piece of advice would you give her, and maybe why?
Well, that's difficult. I think it's very important that you're true to yourself. You try to identify what your passion is, what makes you happy. And I think when you do that, when you are happy, you make others happy. If you have joy in your life, in especially in your work, something we all have to do till we die, or these days, if we're lucky, until we die, and then if you can share that with somebody with enthusiasm and with passion, it's a catching kind of thing. And so I love my work, I love my teaching, and when I was performing a lot, I liked that as much. And I think that my passion for my work and my life, my family, has influenced my students, the young women around me, and I hope that I've been a decent role model.